Oh, my axe, baby!
He picks up his axe, they're all punching him in the head, and he's bending over in combat.
AC 20, AC 22, and a critical fail.
Sir.
That critical first one, fail. So number three. One.
Dex check him fall prone. Brog basically body checks him as he's getting up. Brr!
Doesn't fall prone? Does he not fall prone?
I think he does.
I think he got a 19. Give me a second. With the... Yeah, he got a 19.
He falls. Merman, I'm gonna fall down, Merman!
Good, Brog! Why don't you try killing them?
And he's gonna go after the one with the fewest number of images.
Yep, that's the guy on the ground.
The guy who's injured.
It's that way.
Okay. The guy who's in.
The guy with no images left.
He's got no images. Yep. Oh, yeah. Ba-boom. Yep. There we go.
Oh, and there's some critical misses in there for the monks. So the monks have to make, I think, we've had a couple of them.
We've had three
perform checks. This could go bad for the monks as they're not like doing enough.
Eat.
It's coming.
So they've got acrobatics. They have Bab.
Bab and charisma.
No. They're even on charisma.
Okay.
So three.
They don't have perform, so they're.
Yeah. Oh. 18.
So the crowd has begun to boo the monks. Indifferent, ooh, unfriendly, hostile. So after
the
basically.
Is a hostile?
What's that?
The 18 was the last one.
No, they were at indifferent, and they failed one, which brought it down to
unfriendly.
Unfriendly, and then that one dropped to hostile, and then they didn't go down any further. So the crowd thinks now that the monks cheated because they're outnumbered, and they also cast mirror images. And they expected them to down Brog when Brog bent over, and when Brog stood up and pushed one of them over. They're thinking that the monks aren't good enough. The crowd may take action at the end of the next turn if the monks don't get out of hostile. Like, the crowd might start affecting the fight, is basically what I'm going to do. So the crowd is going to go at one on the next turn.
Farmer runs in. Ah, monkey.
No, so, there are spellcasters and people in the crowd.
His first attack... up for his cleave, he's
yeah, Fox. It's the whole bowling for 20s thing.
AC 26 on the guy with no images.
Okay, that's a hit.
And I'm just gonna roll for the next guy.
What dicks?
Yep.
The crowd has grown surly. They watch so many like monk attacks. They think they're doing it half ass. Damian sidestepping them and making them look stupid.
AC 28 on the
D5.
It's an image.
Wait, how much did Brog hit the blooded monk that stood up?
Yeah, he did. He didn't do damage yet.
Okay.
Demolish. 12 plus 9, and that's 13.
Wait, what?
Plus. Hang on. 13 plus power attack.
Advanced calculus.
Is... Yeah.
The guy that stood up has three images.
Six. Plus...
Foxes might not be wrong. The crowd might not be upset with this. Ooh. The 50,000 gold pieces.
Oh, crappy roll. 22 damage.
He's still up. It's still good. It's still good.
Okay, so that was the AOO from the.
No, that's not the AO.
That's Brog's attack.
That was Brog's attack, and then Brog has a move action?
No, his move is to pick up his axe.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Picked up his weapon. My bad. The crowd's surly and angry. Damien.
If I was smart, I would have had one of the monks pick up his axe when they were stunned. If I was being, like, a dick.
And run away against the other end of the field. Yeah.
Well, this would be the whole...
Right. Damien.
Did they get a performance check for stunning Brogg?
For successful maneuvers, no, I don't think they do.
Okay. They need to do something flashy. Yeah. Need fireworks or something. Funny hat.
Maybe they do, because this caused Brogg to have a condition and drop his weapon, so they can have one more.
16.
It's not enough to get them out of the hole they're in.
All right, yeah, Damien missed twice.
Okay, blooded monks.
They have minus twos for the crowd?
Yep.
Okay.
Crowd, every once in a while, it's throwing things, they're yelling at them, go, you stupid kick punchers!
Dude bro is going to stand for prone.
I told you monks were stupid!
Monks are stupid! Clumps of grass and turf are being thrown at them, some garbage. There might be a spellcaster in the crowd that is reading a spell to try to affect the fight.
From Damien and or Brogg.
I'm sorry, say that again?
AOL from Damien and or Brogg, as the monk who was on his butthook is no longer on his butthook.
Damien, they'll both take AOOs.
Damien is getting up, Damien!
Damien goes first, and then Brogg goes second.
AC 30, how many images?
3. So D4.
Or down an image, and Brogg.
You missed him!
Oh, I keep forgetting. I brought the AC 29.
Okay,
I pulled no fireballs. There's some angry evoker that's not bad enough. Oh, yeah. Damien runs the guy through. Or tries to.
No, that's Brogg.
Brogg.
Oh, Brogg.
Plus 2. 31 damage.
Wow, okay.
All right, that's bad. They're gonna unload their stunning fists and see if that works.
How many more they got?
It's their last ones.
Okay.
Yeah, they had. If you're good at doing the levels, they had 5 each.
Unload them on Brogg.
Yep.
Because Damien the Invincible, the Untouchable.
Damien the Untouchable. Well, then they're just going to be the aid monkeys for the master in a second.
Okay. Yep.
But they need to stop Brogg. Sorry, that should not be. I guess that's they all miss.
Look at those rolls. 8, 13, 9, 5, 2. If that was behind the screen, it'd be like, Marty's taking it easy on us. No, the rolls are fucking...
All right, so then the remainder of the attacks, I added one extra one in there, so I will take off one because I picked it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
misses.
They're all misses.
AC 20.
Nope.
Mm-hmm. Brandon, just play it alone like this. They don't touch you, lady.
he's like flailing his axe around. Right, we're burning, Brandon. We're burning.
They've got 2 more rounds of key. They're running out of juice.
The sensei.
All right.
The sensei sees that this is not going terribly well, but doesn't have a good way of he is going to attack Damien 3 times and then we'll start his actually Damien used an AOO, this is true.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to try to steal his blade 3 times.
Give me that. All right, he's trying to do like twisting your wrist off to the side to try to pull the weapon out of your hands.
He's just a bad. I'm a bad shifu.
I should have learned this.
I mean, the kids in the hall skit. I'm a bad doctor. I'm a bad master.
All right.
No, really, I'm a terrible
it's
master.
It's now Brogg. They have failed to impress the crowd. The crowd is now gathering up many rocks in their hands. Uh-oh. And they might put an end to this stupidity of mirror imaging.
Yeah.
Deflect arrows!
Yeah, they do have that.
Yep. They're about 30 or 40 people armed with rocks now.
Uh-oh. Whoa, okay. All right, 1D. Brog is going to start with the guy he already hit there. With no... Is he 30?
Okay. Are you pulling your punch, sir, in this friendly duel?
No, Brog is smashing him to death.
Brog was instructed by Damian to kill and eat.
I know. So before, when they're like, murder him, eat him, that stuff, yeah. It's like, oh, that's normal shit talk. Cut his head off is going to be not normal shit talk.
Brog! Damian! This one is weak!
He brings his axe into the monk.
32 damage!
The monk's attempt to push the axe out of the way, basically move the axe from here to here, and then it cut into his body. The axe is basically embedded all the way up to his heart. 32 nice. Damage, and the guy that has 74 means he's at minus 15. Minus 20. 59.
He's
minus 15, so he's dead.
He's dead.
Okay.
And this guy.
So he killed that monk, and it's like, oh!
And the next guy, AC 17.
Which one?
The guy adjacent to him.
Okay, roll a d3. Hitting an image.
Nope, that's an image, though.
Performance.
And then Brog's like, he kind of failed. He just sort of had to turn his battle axe or his great axe sideways and kind of moved it towards the monk, knocked an image. And now Brog's sort of like making the monk who's dead dance at the end of his axe as he's trying to shake him off of the axe. The crowd is enjoying this. Give me a performance check for Brog.
All right. He was at plus two, I think.
Yep. Okay.
Nope.
It's part of the crowd is shocked at like just the butchery 70. Of what's supposed to be a subdual match. They aren't booing you guys, however, and the monks failed to impress. At this point, they think the monks are pulling their punches or just weren't the right enemy to face you guys and are booing the monks. And now a hailstorm of rocks, for better or worse, is now coming into the vicinity of the fight.
Okay.
Do you guys have any abilities to block incoming missile attacks?
I do not.
A bunch of deflect arrows.
Okay. Yes. All right. The master loses one less, so he loses two images.
Okay.
The monk to the south of him loses 1d3 minus one images. He loses one. The monk to the south of him loses two images.
Okay, he's naked.
The monk that got hit, who still has a couple of images left, to Damien's left, loses one image.
Okay, he's naked.
Brog, while they weren't targeting Brog, these are commoners with rocks, he's going to get 1d2 rocks to the bean. He gets two rocks to the bean for six damage. And Damian, they weren't targeting you. You don't have...
I do not, no.
You don't have... you lose two images by accident.
Okay.
Some of the soldiers are beginning to move into the crowd to stop the rock throwing, and a few people get punched or bludgeoned in the nose for this. Crowds are not supposed to... they're not supposed to directly affect the outcome, and there are people being arrested, but it is sort of a chaotic melee in a non-standard place to fight. Yeah. Like, there aren't people in seats that you can easily go and get. The crowd is soon dispersing in that area, and people pushing against the soldiers. There's lots of yelling, but the rock throwing has stopped. But
does Magnus say anything? There's a lot of stuff going on. Like,
no, like yeah,
does Magnus enjoy this fight? Does he think it's funny that, you know,
Magnus
Damian
has a
is
beer.
Going back to the head of the rock?
Magnus was given a beer. He's got this big sign.
I'm not drinking anything anyone gives me.
Oh, okay.
He's worried Chebigast is going to poison him.
The irony of that statement.
Somebody else might.
Let's just remember the poisoning statement. Okay.
foreshadowing.
All right, that was the crowd. The crowd...
Did their thing,
Damian.
Damian is going to attack. The first attack is on the master.
Okay, who has one image left.
Yeah. I've been screwing.
He looks really nervous.
Uh-oh.
Plus 5, minus 2. I should be a plus 17. What am I doing?
I don't know.
You're trying to take it easy on these poor...
Critical threat?
Yeah.
Roll D2. One is a hit.
Oh.
Roll to confirm the critical.
There is a good stuff. There is a big money.
No.
Oh, 19 is not a critical hit against the master, but you do hit him in the shoulder with your rapier.
27 points of damage.
Oh, that's kind of gross.
That was minimum.
Why are you so gross?
That is minimum damage.
Okay, that was not a successful crit, so you don't get a performance check. Then it's the bloodied monks.
No, I get another attack.
Or the blooded. Oh, sorry.
And I'm going to attack the monk behind him that has no images.
Okay. The one that's already injured. So, fah!
Fah! 12.
Oh. Nat 1.
Fumble.
Fucking dick.
I want the NPC to win.
28.
Would it hit? Okay. Would it, should have, yep. Could it. Blooded monks.
All right. The blooded monks are going to aid the master.
They should do that with their last attacks.
You think it's a standard aid. They can't, like, punch aid. It'd be aid.
Oh, you can't do it as an attack. It's a standard? Okay.
Yeah. So they're going to aid the master in the master's first thingy. And they're going to spend a key point on AC.
Okay. What's the check? Is this a disarm, or is this a...
And they're going to spread around Brogg in a way that they don't get freaking cleaved anymore.
Fair enough.
They can't cleave the lap. They're just aiding the next attack roll. So they don't have to say disarm or whatever. But it's going to be a disarm.
Just roll AC 10s.
I don't know if they could do this, man. They kind of suck. Can you be flanked?
Can Damian? Yes, Damian can be flanked.
All right. So the first one has a plus 2 on it. Two of them could do it. One of them can't even help.
Okay, so there's plus 4 to the next attack roll from their masters, and then that's it. They use their key points for defense. Is that... Now it's the sensei.
All right. The sensei is going to attempt to take away your pointy murder stick.
Okay. He's got forks, got cutlery, he's still good.
He really wants the blade, Mark. Give it to him.
Alright, so he's gonna take away your pointy murder stick. He's gonna attempt to disarm you. 31 on the disarm.
No.
Ooh.
Alright.
Does it hit within 5? Because would this then get rid of an image if it's within 5 of the CMD?
No, it's not within 5.
Okay. He just pulls the blade away.
This CMD of like 40 is real good.
He's got the big dodge bonus from Crane Stand. Fighting defensively. And
Brogg, he's got his plus 2 decks. Fighting defensively. He's
No, the bastard's going to punch Damien in the face. Okay. That was just the first one.
Is it not a standard to discern?
No, it's just added as an attack roll. He's then going to try a stunning fist you. Nah, he'll save the stunning. Maybe he'll need it in hell. and he got stabbed last time, so he'll spend the key point on AC.
Alright, now it's Brogg.
More bullshittery than...
There are two monks beside Brogg that do not have mirror images, and one of them is really injured, standing above the one that Brogg looks like he wants to eat, so he's going to attack the injured one, because Brogg is efficient in his killing.
Corpse pearl is what he says.
The AC you're trying to hit is AC 28.
Oh, this guy tries to block the axe and it just comes crashing through his blocking kata. Plus. Too quick, too strong.
Plus, yeah.
Now biting into flesh and bone, he's crying out in pain.
Two from Birdsong. 32 damage.
He is unconscious. And
yep.
King. Oh, he likes him twitching.
You're fresh.
I'll call you up later. I'll
put the barbecue sauce on him.
Yum, yum.
And as a move action, he's going to give Damian half his bonus against the master.
Okay, humans.
Hey, that's a smart thing.
Bam, get the leader. Got one.
There's some advice, Rog. Thank you.
get him where the soft bits.
Okay.
Here's the pointy end.
The crowd is being pacified by the soldiers. They're like the occasional rock comes flying in, but
Do we get a perform check?
Because we downed a person, yep.
Yeah. Nope.
Okay. There are people too.
Damien's turn.
19 against him.
Berman. Berman, we're AC winning.
34.
Berman. AC 34 is a possible critical. Yes. Against whom?
Against the master.
Okay.
It's a miss.
He is. AC 34 is miss?
It's a miss. Screw you,
miss?
Buddy.
Well, that's
yeah,
that's
spent a key
that
point.
That pops that image, AC. Though. AC is actually 35.
Okay.
It's 17, so 12 against the monk.
He sidesteps
north,
the blow, but the image sidestepped and caught the blade. There are no more images around the master,
okay,
sensei, and only a single
monk 4.
Okay. Who has one image left?
Yes. Blooded Monk 4 has an image left?
Yes.
This guy?
No.
Sorry, I was reading Blooded Monk non-lethal.
Blooded Monk 1 with 4 non-lethal damage has an image.
Okay, you attack the one that doesn't have any images left.
Ah, bring him, soften him up, bring him.
Plus
12
damage. There we go.
Put his head against the rock, bring him.
Oh, natural 20.
Uh-oh.
Plus 12.
Oh, bring him, that's bad.
Mark, why can't you figure this out?
Skewer him like fish, bring him.
26.
Not a crit. But
he spent
screw
his
you.
Plus 4 on...
He's played his plus 4 on dodging. They try to dodge.
Berman!
Shut up. That's 26. 28 damage.
Here's the 28 that you need.
Okay, so you turned your attack from the master to the blooded monk and sort of caught him paying attention to Brogg. And
you're more of a monster than he!
3 inches of blade goes into his side. Oh! And you know, he's limping.
Why are you killing? Stop killing them! What the fuck?
Your gladiators are reckless, and they will get their comeuppance, says this man beside you.
Eat, Brog, eat! I never wanted that froggy shit, and he's an ass.
It appears that they're going out of their way to kill the monks. What say you?
This is I have a merciful blade. I aim never to kill.
And yet your merciful blade is outside the arena. Shame on you, Magnus.
Headbutt him. Headbutt him in the nose.
I don't know. What's wrong with you? I haven't fought yet.
This is supposed to be a non-lethal match. A match to submission.
Yeah, I have no idea what the hell he's doing. Damien, what the fuck are you doing?
You should have more control over your gladiators as a Lannister, a trainer of gladiators, as a champion.
He's royalty. Not royalty. He's citizen.
Nobility.
Nobility. Nobility, I mean.
So that nobility. So that is an excuse. A poor one at that.
Okay. You know what? Fuck you.
I see. Then the fault does lie with you.
Yeah, fuck you doubly. Here, do this. Magnus puts his hand at him. Come on, huh?
My masters will know of your dishonor here today.
It's fucking him.
And so fuck will you, and so will all of the faith of Heronius.
Oh, Heronius, yeah, whatever. Okay. Just leans to the guy next to him. Who the fuck is Heronius?
Okay, who's next? the blooded monks did their thing. The Sensei did his thing.
I think it's have knowledge religion.
Brogg?
I don't
know. Wait.
Damian just attacks.
Damian, so the blooded monks.
Okay. They are gonna attack. Dave didn't work for me. They're going to boo the crowd to see if more rocks come to take away Damien's images. No, they're not going to do that. But they should do that. If they were smart, they'd do that. They're going to... okay.
Right.
not a safe place to be.
So, Blood Monk with the mirror image is going to come over here. And he's going to attack Brogg 2 times, and he will save his last key point. The monk at the bottom is going to attack Brogg 2 times, and he will use a key point for defense. That's his last key point. The guy's got a key point. The monk... The monk master will sit there and go, ooh, look how powerful I am. Yeah. All right. 4 attacks on Brogg. With the booing and crowd helping. AC 20 is the best.
No.
Hey, they're slapping Brogg amongst his froggy bits. Almost dead monk is going to 5 foot step back.
Kensei Master, or the Sensei Master.
He is going to step down and beat the ever-living piss out of Brogg.
Okay.
Because, damn it, Brogg. he needs to hit something. He's just out there. the first attack will be a stun. AC 20 is a miss. AC 23 is I don't know. AC 25... so 2 hits.
Right.
There's
a stunning fist in there.
The stunning fist was the first one.
Oh, it missed? Okay.
It missed. It missed, and it was not done on purpose.
Okay, he comes in with a flurry of blows. Brogg kind of blocks the first one, but right. He shifts instead of trying to punch Brogg in the face, just punching him in the belly, and it's hurting Brogg.
Okay, 19 lethal damage.
Ooh.
Because he's not happy.
Okay.
Brogg's go.
Bearman, fuck this guy.
Brogg is going to attack the monk. With his tongue.
He could do this as a secondary attack, you realize.
Okay, he'll do it as a secondary attack. He will fly.
I think I might be able to... Is the tongue considered a reach weapon?
Yeah, 10 feet.
10 feet away, it keeps you from going away.
Yeah.
Oh, I was wondering if he can deflect it. Can he deflect the tongue?
it's a...
All right, he's going to take a shot at Blooded Monk 1 first.
Okay.
with the image?
Yeah.
Brayman, I got this one, Brayman.
Natural 20.
Which one, Brayman?
Oh, wrong one.
No, Brayman! I got it right now, Brayman!
And the, I guess it's just a ranged attack or an attack?
The tongue attack, it is just a reach weapon.
But is it a strength weapon, or...?
The sticky tongue...
Well, I guess, yeah, it'd be a strength attack, I guess. It's not a ranged attack. All right.
So it's melee minus 5 because you're doing it as a secondary, but yeah, it just has to be a touch AC. 18.
That should be plus 18. So minus 6, so plus
12. Okay. Tongue goes flipping out towards the guy who's trying to get away. The 5-foot step.
No, right? It's trying to hit the master.
Okay.
AC is 31, but touch. 4 of that is not touch.
So he's got a on his tongue. And he's got a minus 2 in his AC right now.
Right. The master has to make a standard action or can deal slashing damage to get the tongue off of him. Otherwise, he can't move more than 10 feet away from the target.
You're going to punch that tongue, are you, buddy?
Punching the tongue will not do anything. Damien.
I think taking the tongue out of the Brog Fae skull is the way to solve this issue. Although with his tiny little strength, I don't know if he can.
I'm on them.
It's attacking the master. Come on.
The tongue was in the way, distracting you. Like, ah! He knew you were going to attack and avoid the tongue, so he blocked near that way. And...
Critical miss. Oh.
Some saliva got in your face.
40.
40 on the critical miss chart. Is a lose next standard action.
Okay.
So you have your secondary attack, but your next round you don't have your standard.
I am going to...
Unless it's one that ends your...
the next standard action you have, so...
Yeah. I'm just going to attack the master again.
Because you're overreaching and you got saliva on you and you're trying to not hit the tongue.
19, so 14.
Your footing's all wrong.
Okay. No, AC 23.
Okay.
Performance check.
Right, because it's a...
Boo everyone! Boo all the things! Boo this
everyone
bullshittery.
Just starts pelting rocks. They don't care who it is.
27.
Oh, no. They're fine with you overreaching on a single attack, and it shows that you're human. not just some killing machine. Blooded Monks, and then the Sensei Monks.
Okay. The Blooded Monks... Okay, everybody's hurt.
He's not going away, man. He's not going away.
This is going to step in. They're going to unload on Brock.
Okay.
AC 24 this time.
The man to the north who is still alive will save his key point.
This is when Brock goes down, I have a feeling.
They're going to... Actually, no, he'll spend his key point to attack. We are going to stop Brog. So 5 number 1d20 plus 4. AC critical threat, AC 22 and AC 24.
AC 24 hits, AC 22 does not.
Okay. Not a critical hit. 10 lethal.
What's max damage? I think you get a performance check.
Stop booing me, you sons of bitches!
Just dig your way out of hostile land, no? but 10 damage on Brog is significant, especially at this point in the fight. The sensei...
It's good at...
I don't think there's any penalty for having the tongue on him, just you can't move away.
And it's a minus 2 AC, according to his character sheet. Yeah, but there's no penalty to hit.
Oh, yeah, he's got a minus 2 AC. Okay. It's not Brog that has a minus 2 AC.
Yeah.
Okay.
The monk does. Yep. Okay, but if I kill Brog, does the tongue stop?
Or... Yeah, it goes away. Yeah.
Okay, so attack Brog. the first one will be a stun. God damn you, monk. AC 22 and AC
23. No.
He's just sort of yanking the monk around. He's trying to punch Brog. Brog.
Blooded monks. Oh, Brog?
Yeah.
All right. Brog is...
Well, blooded monks, hit four. Only once. Yeah. Hit only once.
Sorry. No, the master thinks he's safe.
Alright.
Who's Brog attacking with his mighty axe?
Monk, Blooded Monk 4, I think it is.
Okay.
The guy, yeah.
Get your knuckle and plug it off!
Natural 20.
That's it! That's it! Get your knuckle!
Okay.
Can't handle it.
Oh, and another 20.
Okay. Critical hit. He's taking the crit. Give me a percentile.
One.
Oh.
It's a reduced. That's
reduced critical.
Still
and
double
it,
damage.
But a free,
still dead.
A free combat maneuver, no AOO, and there's double damage on the die.
Double damage is going to kill, so.
Yeah. So.
With the reduced crit in the table,
yep.
The multi-crit weapons are still really good. Like, picks and axes.
Plus four.
They were finding in the other campaign abyssal steel scimitars.
Yeah, those are
18
gross.
Through 20 times three.
Times
crit.
Three crit. Oh my god.
51 damage. Okay, 51 brings him to 79, which is minus 20. Brog cut off his head.
And free combat maneuver. No AOO.
It's against the person that you were attacking.
I think he's going to eat.
Okay, he's gonna grapple him into his mouth.
Okay, so he actually catches the head in his mouth and swallows it. There's a bunch of like quiet roar, like just a quiet a wave of the crowd as they're watching the body stumble back and kind of a couple of spurts of blood come out of the neck and it unceremoniously.
21 on the performance check.
people love it. You guys are now not just friendly, but it's helpful. As the crowd is chanting, Conclave, Conclave, Conclave.
Feel bad, Magnus. This is your responsibility, Magnus.
The paladin just basically shakes his head and slowly walks away from Magnus.
dude.
He's not mine.
Conclave, Conclave.
They're shouting your students.
Yeah, good, you bloodthirsty fuckers.
Conclave, Conclave. All right. top of the round, it's Damian. And the master can't retreat.
Damian has no standard action.
Oh, okay, so you only have a move.
Yeah.
You kind of reset your footing, and you look at Brog, who's swallowing the
murdered this
the
round.
Head. Blooded monk, the only one that's left standing.
It's gonna get Brog. Killed everyone.
You do notice the paladin kind of go like this with his hands. You're pretty sure he stabilized the bloody monk that's on the ground.
Murderer.
Everyone's already booing and chanting for blood.
He's still yelling, murderer.
Right. He just.
You killed him. You killed all of them. He has no steady fists. He's got no key powers. He's just scratched on the surface. Why?
Oh, Damian, are you gonna take that one?
The sensei can't get away because of the tongue.
He's gonna pound on Brog. He will stun Brog with his last stunning fist because we're at that point in the fight. What am I saying? He'll stun Brog.
It happened once already.
He gets to hit once. Brog.
Nope. Right into Brog's plate. Oh, a critical hit. This time you punched Brog in the big bug eye.
Nope.
And a miss. Ka-chung, 9 damage. Lethal.
Alright, Brog takes that 9 damage and is still standing.
Yeah, I think he's almost in rage hit points right now.
He's getting there. Very, very close.
Single digit hit points.
Die.
Which brings us to Brog.
Brayman, we gotta kill someone, Brayman. I can't do all the work.
Monk's gonna dance here because he can go within 10 feet.
Right.
So.
Yeah, Brog is going to attack the blooded monk 1.
Okay.
Brayman, you gotta kill someone, Brayman. Why did I bring you in here, Brayman?
36.
It's like he's cutting cordwood. downward swings.
This monk has some non-lethal padding where he punched himself in the dick.
6 plus 2. There we go. That's 20. 28 points of damage.
He's still up. He's good. He will knock you out. It's the mighty fight between the dude with the -2 from the crowd making him need 20s to hit.
Okay. It is Bamian's go.
Is Brog... The monks are out of their powers. How close is Brog to running out of rage?
Brog's got tons of fucking rage.
His con is through the roof. He has 18 rounds of rage per day.
Oh, no. Okay, never mind. It's a long, very long time.
Fifth level barbarian with a 22 con.
And he runs out of hit points before he runs out of rage.
Yeah.
Okay, he moves in there. 5 foot.
Okay, the tongue is kind of awkwardly going through that square, but sure.
Jump tongue.
Oh, as a move action, Brog gives Damian half the bonus again.
Okay.
Damian, get him. Get him, my dude.
Brog's voice is even more fun when his tongue is out.
You'll get him, Damian.
AC 30.
Yuck!
Who are you getting?
The master.
With the -2 nonsense from this touch attack tongue baloney.
It just, he's trying to like go back into proper kata, but every few moments, like there's a jerk from the tongue that pulls him forward. He gets yanked into the blade. You have
31 damage.
You have no honor, says the monk to Damian as you're really close to him, as you're running him through.
So at what level of number of hit points would he attempt to submit?
Single digit, probably.
So I think this is what he wants
on
now.
His turn. Yep.
Yeah.
Is he still standing?
Yeah.
Okay. The blooded monk.
No, I got another attack.
Oh, right.
Oh. You just needed to roll your other attack.
I just had to, because I'm an asshole. Oh. Can I use a victory point to negate that?
I believe they're like hero points. You could add like, not hero points, they're like, mythic points you could add to D6s to
There's
rolls.
Mythic surge.
Yep.
Can I do it after the fact?
Do we let mythic points negate ones?
No.
No.
Okay.
Altigar took power specifically because that is a miss.
AC 28?
Yep. 29 with the tongue.
Critical miss.
And he's 6. That's bad.
Oh.
96 is critical self by accent, auto-confirmed roll on critical chart.
Oh, that's brutal.
So finally, he tried to, like, once again pull the weapon out of your hand. It actually kind of pulled.
Can I use it? Oh, it's supposed to be an immediate action. I have a spell that lets me negate crits as an immediate action.
Does it work against magic weapons?
Yeah.
Okay, so there's an immediate action. It is called what? Did you use a switch?
Randomly is also making a very strong suggestion.
Yep.
You might want to check chat, Mark.
I'm looking in chat.
Okay, if you have a victory point, you put the victory point on your roll to not crit. Not the attack roll, but the confirmed roll.
No, it's auto-confirmed.
No. On the 1d20 plus 14, like 28, yeah. Where you miss by 1 to not...
Like so if I add the D6 automatically, yes. I thank you. not thinking straight at midnight. Yes, I will do that. There's my victory point. That's
okay. So you spend the victory point not to have
Dude,
the blade.
You almost died.
critical cell by accident auto-confirmed. What would the percentile have, like, roll on critical chart? So you'd roll again. What would the percentile have been?
Let's just, can we just see what the future could have been?
Yeah,
when he sees the oracle, this will be the vision.
47 would have been standard crit with 1d3 to a random ability score.
Oh.
It would have been 3 to your int. So basically the sword got bent backwards and stabbed into your head. And then the crit damage to self.
The double damage?
Yeah.
Or do you times 3 crit?
No, I don't times 3 crit. No.
Okay, not yet.
Oh, apparently I need an abyssal steel rapier, because that's the way to go.
Sounds like a quest to me.
Yeah.
Sounds like a quest worth having.
plus 46.
You can't keen it, but who cares?
Yeah, it would have been 54 damage.
Then save versus death.
Yeah.
And then a fort save versus death. Give me a fort save. I want to see what the history could have been had
your victory has not been so
had
great.
Randomly not been paying attention.
He would have
survived this.
He would have had a massive.
So basically, you saw like like you came in and you kind of bent your hand back and the blade was like pointing to your face. You're like, whoa. And you missed and didn't critical miss. That was your first attack or second attack?
Second attack.
Okay, now it is the remaining bloodied monk. You don't have to make a performance check because it wasn't actually a critical miss.
Okay.
I think he's going to step back and submit.
Okay, he raises his fingers and submits.
Actually, he steps over the wounded foe and submits.
Before booing, the monk backed out. The sensei, he's got the tongue on him.
The sensei pulls the tongue off and then submits.
Actually, you need to make a roll to pull the tongue off.
Then he just okay. What's the roll?
It is a standard action. Strength check. Opposed strength check.
Oh, good luck.
11.
Well, let's see if I roll a 1.
30 strength.
I rolled a 20.
Then he submits with the tongue.
All right.
At his 2 hit points.
Mermaid, what does that mean? Mermaid, give up?
Magnus is like, please don't fucking kill him. Please don't kill him.
Damien says, he looks tasty.
Okay, so you're instructing Brogg to keep fighting?
No.
Okay.
He gave up.
The tongue kind of goes back into Brog's mouth.
But he points at the guy beneath the... Yeah. This monk, but he didn't.
Which one?
The living
pile?
One. Yeah, the living guy.
The one that the Huronian paladin stabilized.
Okay, so the tongue goes stuck onto the guy's corpse.
Grapple him in.
You can't pull with the tongue. Although, like, frogs can. There is a horn that goes off.
Great editor of the games, says Kythan,
the Unchained, as he swirls the chains around for a moment.
Who is the victor of this match?
The Conclave of Crimson Scale wins.
The blind man's kind of staring off. Maybe he was, like, visualizing the battle. You don't know how he determined that. This monk is screaming bloody murder and kind of like hopped on the corpse as Brog is trying to like pull him in.
Damian, did they give up?
I'm assuming the monk is no longer, the chief monk is helping and he's no longer connected to the tongue if the tongue is doing something else.
Yep.
Hey, Brog,
Damian taps Brog, it's over.
Brog, you want me to eat?
No, it's done. You had your chance. They called the bell.
Okay. He takes a 5-foot step back and instead takes the body that is headless and puts it upside down and just starts drinking the blood out of the body.
Damien kind of takes a step away from that.
He could have stepped towards.
Holy fuck, Siskoff, as he hops down from the... are you sure that guy's not a monster? Maybe he should be in the beast stables! And people start laughing. All right, that's enough, Brog.
Okay.
Brog just tosses the corpse down. The monks are like breathing and panting, but just giving you the dirtiest of looks. More desecration. Heaps upon heaps of shame, says the paladin to Magnus and Damian.
We'll read your poetry somewhere else.
Yes, but it's not the shame of loss now, is it?
Okay, Magnus is starting to stretch.
What did you say your god's name was? Erroneous?
That's funny right there.
Sounds wrong to me.
If you did not just fight, I would. I would fight you for the honor of my deity now. Perhaps we will meet in honorable combat, if you learn what that is.
Well, I shall endeavor to try.
This blood money today will not repay and pay for your sins against the gods.
Yes. Oh, yes. Blood money. I almost forgot. 10,000 a head. 10 talents.
I'm assuming there's a monk who's really upset and expecting repayment so that he could bring his men back to life.
Yeah, the monks have just fought. They don't want to. They don't want to do anything right now. They have dragged over the still living one. Brog just wanders over.
Hey, man, I didn't get to eat any of them, Damian.
What are you talking about? You had one in your mouth.
but they told me to put it down.
No one told you to put it down. You had your chance.
Does he have his head still?
Oh, the head was swallowed. It is.
Yeah, he's got the head. Dog.
Yep.
Magnus.
What the fuck do you want?
You're fighting next.
Yeah.
What do you think you're fighting?
The fuck? I don't know. Hopefully, it doesn't kill me.
There's a slippery spot right over there.
Yeah, no problem.
Where I was standing, it's Magnus, really hot.
Magnus.
What?
Do you think the thing you're fighting is tasty?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know, Brog. I'll let you know. How was that?
I'm going to step away because I got to go to bed. I got a meeting in the morning. Okay. But I'm going to play this. I'm going to be streaming Twitch on my phone with earbuds in and sleeping. That is my plan. Is to have dreams of conquest.
They clear the bodies. The bodies are cleared towards where the monks are standing. And this strange Ephraim Demos the Blind just looking upon everything. It looks like he's the editor here. And now for the match we've all been waiting for!
Oh, yeah.
Magnus, the Magnificent of the Conclave of Crimson Scale! Champion of the Spring Games! Versus a terrible beast found from the hinterlands, captured by Imperial wizards, and now under the dominating control of Chabagas the Beast Tamer.
Where's my other Magnus?
You can hear the Magnus coming closer, or the beast coming closer. The terrible, the wicked, the poisonous.
Ah, fucking balls.
Venomanticore.
Uh-oh.
Dragging this great beast forward in chains is a massive creature. What's missing from the token, it does have wings like bat. You do notice that there is one woman that seems to be one of the two wizards or sorceresses is concentrating on the beast, while the other one, and kind of barking at the occasional command, the other one seems to be casting a spell and looking at Magnus.
Magnus goes
to the glory! To the victor goes the glory and the spoils!
Magnus is already tapping spells. He's tapping Barkskin and Shield.
Okay, Magnus taps his two spells. You notice that the woman, Rala, who is watching Magnus, whispers something to Chebagast. Chebagast looks to Kaithan. Kaithan looks to you. You have two powers by rules of this match.
Two weapons, two powers, one armor.
Shing.
Merciful blade.
There are those that are watching you closely, Magnus. Be careful. I think it's poisonous.
Let Cord decide how this battle ends.
Magnus!
The creature speaks.
Fuck.
Magnus! Meet!
Hmm. Okay.
Beast against fury! Rage against monster! But which one is which? We shall find out who is the stronger, the Northern Corsican champion or the Venomanticore.
See how this fucking thing goes.
Its tail kind of twitches a little bit, and you can see spines coming out of its tail. The spines are dripping with poison, and it's it gets almost like an instant before the fight begins, like its entire mangy hide gets kind of slimy, almost like it's like sweating, like wet with its own sweat. Initiative.
Yep.
As the Venomanticore is, and we could just roll with all bonuses in chat.
No, okay, I have to add my bonus.
It gets a 12.
I have a 13, I believe, because I have a plus 4.
And did they say it gets any powers or not? I forget. What were the stipulations of the match?
It only limited me. There were no details about the powers on the thing itself.
Okay. You do notice that the creature is wearing an amulet.
Really, Chebagast? Amulet? Come on! It doesn't need it!
Chebagast kind of goes... He seems happy with himself.
May the fight begin!
And the bell gets rang by the spiked chain. And the Venomanticore digs in.
Magnus needs some spices to his meat.
It beats its wings a little bit. Go ahead.
Spring attack.
You notice that the soldiers are keeping the crowd back. Like, the crowd is not pushing right to the edge. They're keeping at least 10 feet back. All the way around. Chebagast doesn't seem to mind. He is kind of keeping away from the Manticore. Even Kaithan the Unchained steps back from this.
So Magnus does a
spring attack.
It's a spring attack. I'm wondering if I should lunge as well. I'm defensively spring attacking. Let's see what this thing is like.
Defensively spring attacking.
Yes.
Oh, double Marty across the sky. Two. What does it mean, man? What does it mean?
So a minus 4. D20 plus 2. So minus 2. Okay. This is my merciful blade. 33.
AC 33? Yeah, you strike it easily with that hit.
Wow!
Okay.
It does not like you.
That's fine. I don't like it either.
28 damage.
Okay, that gets reduced. What is your weapon?
My weapon is +1, merciful.
Was this non-lethal?
Yes, it's non-lethal.
Okay, so it does 23 non-lethal.
Sorry, dude, it's undead.
Wham! When you dodged in, you actually went within a poisonous aura. Like the air just around it is poisonous. You need to make a fortitude save.
Yep.
As you inhale some of the poison around its aura.
Okay, can I be aware of that and start holding my breath? Next round.
Nah, it still gets you. So.
Okay.
Magnus.
25.
Actually, yes, you can. So you caught a whiff of it. Oh, that stinks. You could start holding your breath. And yes.
How would that work? Could I basically like move around, go like, and go in, kind of.
So I think your round is over now, right?
Yes.
But you could begin holding your breath now if you wanted.
Okay.
Can Damien do a bard song for him?
Yeah, so the crowd right now is friendly, so you actually have one higher.
So another damage?
And the crowd is indifferent towards the... No, it's just an attack.
Just a hit, okay. Been a while since I've done this.
Damien...
The Bartong will give you another +1 to hit.
And +2 to damage. Okay, so Damien is striking up a bard song. He is...
Performance?
Performance? What performance, yeah.
Comedy.
Okay, so you're making fun of the stinky thing and...
Meow! I'm a shitty cat!
people are laughing and Magnus can hear. The Venomanticore does not like that. The Venomanticore is going to... Let's see. It is going to pounce.
Yep.
It charges and pounces at Magnus. You are now within its poison aura.
That's bad.
But you are now.
Hello.
Yeah. I'm
Does your bard song give me a bonus to saves?
No.
I'm not. What the fuck, guy?
I'm not mythic. I'm sorry.
Okay. What is your AC?
God damn it, Marty. God damn, Marty. You make me scared, hell. AC is 32.
Really?
Yes.
Because shield and your armor?
Shield, barkskin, defensive, dodge, armor, dex.
Okay. Because that's pretty strong.
Yeah.
Okay. So he does a bite, claw, claw. AC 20, AC 22, AC 24. Look at those fucking rolls. 3, 5, 7.
Exactly how I like them. Okie dokie, this is going to be a rough fight. Verified.
You're holding your breath. Okay. So what's your con right now?
My con is 20. It's like 20. It's 20. No, imagine it's 18.
18? Okay, you have 36 breath points. So yep. BP 36.
Okay, now I have to read a few things. Now,
its tail is shaking. There are spikes that are in the tail. You're in its fumy cloud, but you are holding your breath. So you don't have to make a save. However, its claws and bite look like they're dripping with poison, and so so is its mangy hide.
I just wanted to check on my I believe distance, but you must move at least. Can I use it to the start of your turn? Okay, so well, no more spring attacks.
Nope.
I'm not going to fight defensively. Actually, no, I will continue to fight defensively. I'm going to full round this thing. How many points does that take me? Does it take from me?
2 per round. If you do something combative.
Okay, so it's going to be plus... I get 2 from the bonus from you. 15, so plus... 7, so not... No more of this. So plus 15 and then plus 10.
Okay. Missed?
Yep.
You kind of sidestepped your blade.
24.
And missed by 2, but it charged, so you hit.
Okay. Is it 18? Just confirming that number. Yes. No, plus 20, right? 2 more from your Bart song. 30 damage, so 25 damage.
So you have a plus 18 from what?
My plus 18 is weapon, 7 strength.
So plus 10 for two-handed.
3 from two-handed, so it becomes 11. 6 power attack, becomes 17. 1 from weapon training, 18.
18 plus, okay. Plus,
and then 2 from the Bart song.
Bart song, okay. And it's 3d6 because?
It's 2d6 and then plus 1d6 when it's non-lethal, you had an extra
d6. Okay, right. Okay, so 30 non-lethal becomes 25.
How's it looking?
Not bloodied yet.
Yeah, I didn't think it was, but is it quarter blooded?
Breathe! This is what he's saying. Breathe it in! It is now going to full round, or does it breathe its breath weapon? Okay. It spews poison all over you. This is from a breath weapon, so holding your breath doesn't do anything. You just kind of like sprays a bunch of poison.
It goes in your eyes and shit. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it goes in your eyes. It is making you very, very faint. And okay. You need to make a fortitude save. Let me calculate this. It's plus another 3, so DC 24 fort save.
Holy fuck. I could really use a hero point here if this doesn't. Yeah. I'm fine.
Okay.
I'm fine.
A successful save halves the ability damage and negates the special effect.
Oh.
I want to use my point to fail it. So I think it's not automatic fail, but you could use a villain point, Nemi, to make him
re-roll it.
Re-roll it, and take whatever result it is. Oh. So are you going to use your villain point to do that? We'll wait to roll until we get a confirmation from Nemi.
Yep.
Yes. Okay. So you fail by 2.
I want to... Can I rage?
No, that's a feat.
Oh, fuck.
Okay, you get sprayed by this poison. It's in your eyes and it's in your face. It's like huffing. It's like fumes. So the first thing that it does is... Does 5 int damage.
Oh, no.
The second thing it
does... I can't use it. I'm not raging yet, random.
Is 4 wisdom damage.
Okay.
And you are now bewildered and confused and kind of forget where you are. You have the confusion.
I can't use any of this, guys. I don't have my...
He's not raging right now. Yeah.
I'm not raging. That's why I was trying to rage so that I can use it.
So, Magnus is confused.
So, tell me what the hell's going on here. Confused. I've got minus 4.
5 int damage, 4 wisdom damage, and it can breathe again in 2 rounds.
We're going to have to tie a rope around
minus 5 int, minus 4 wisdom. Off. And it can breathe again in how much?
Oh.
Two rounds. So I guess I'm not doing anything.
Well, it's now Magnus. It's going to 5 foot step back from you just to see if you like it or not. If you don't act normally, I'm going to say you end up breathing because you're kind of
yeah.
in a wonky state. Yeah. So let's look up confusion.
Oh, God damn it.
You're lucky I didn't advance this monster totally to 11th level because this is a... Screw it, I used a point. So what I don't want to do is to have just hero points negate totally villain points.
Yeah.
So let's see what would happen on Magnus's turn and see if we want to spend it. Okay. So give me a percentile.
It's okay. It's okay for now, Foxfire. It's okay.
Give me a percentile.
Okay, 43.
43 does nothing but babble incoherently, which means you're now breathing in its aura poison. Which is different. So a hero point would give Magnus a +4. Now the chat's fighting with hero points and villain points.
See, that's I don't think it should be used in the same event, either a hero point or a villain point. Like you know, something happens, either use this or that. I don't want people burning up their points to negate each other. I don't think that's cool.
So maybe a hero point to roll twice on the confusion effect and take the more desirable one? Is that reasonable?
I'm
would,
fine
would
with
you
what
spend
it is right
would
now.
You spend a hero point on that, Fox?
I don't want that. I'm fine with Magnus taking this.
Technically, a hero point does give you a +4 retroactive bonus to a roll, which would mean that
he makes the save.
Fine. There's a limited amount. There's a limited amount of hero points, and we did do this last game where there was this like cascade of hero and villain points. So I'm going to ask clearly: do you want to use the hero point to +4 Magnus? No, I'll keep the point. Okay, great.
Okay. Cool.
All right. So Magnus is babbling incoherently, and you're within 10 feet of the venomous manticore. So you do need to make a fortitude save against its poison cloud, which is a different type of poison. The DC of this is 24.
Nope, failed.
Okay, so you're poisoned with this, and this is 1d3 strength, which is 3 strength damage.
Oh, there's going to be nothing left of you.
and you have the sickened condition.
Oh, 3. Fuck. So minus 3, which means 2 points. Okay.
Do smell it, Magnus. Do smell what Vino has for you.
Magnus like, do Magnus incoherent babbling.
No.
Okay. So that was your round. The manticore is going to stay there and start whipping spikes at you.
Okay. I'm not defensive anymore, right?
No, you know what? It's just going to... Wait. It goes full defense.
Okay.
If you smell the manticore, it's cooking. Oh, wow, fuck this thing. Here, do you guys want to see what this thing is? This is the base monster. Don't look at it, Ahmed. This is the base monster. Then I added advanced simple template. And I think I gave it heroic ability scores on top of that.
Oh.
And like a feat or two and some more hit points. It's basically I took a CR6 and went, what can I do with this? It's full defensing.
Okay.
Which means that Magnus now gets to roll confusion.
This is a disgusting even for a CR6.
68?
Yeah, it's not a CR6. A successful save has the ability damage. The confusion lasts for 1 round per hit dice of the poisonous creature. Okay. So your percentile?
68.
68 on the confusion means you deal 1d8 plus strength modifier to yourself with the weapon in hand. So you're going, bang! I'm going to consider this 5. Non-lethal because it's a non-lethal weapon.
So 12 damage.
You kind of start hitting yourself with the sword a little bit.
And Damian, what's BP? Whether he wants to go up any more ranks.
Yep.
What's BP?
Breath points. You could just nuke those. You are now breathing in the poison. You're breathing it in.
Okay.
Okay. Now it's the creature's turn. It goes full defense. It is now still exuding the poison in a 10-foot aura. I think when you continue to be in contact with poison, once per round, give me a second, and this one is actually an effect. Okay, so you need to make another fort save. This was on your turn.
20.
Okay, so you've made one save, and
I've saved you twice from this.
Yeah, you don't take any strength damage, but then you take another dose on its turn. You take another dose of the inhaled first poison, one. So the DC bumps up.
Okay.
Oh god.
And it full defenses.
Oh my god.
So now it's confusion effect. I actually think I need a
94.
Attack nearest creature. For the purpose, the familiar counts as part of the subject. Okay, so you are actually going in to attack it. You can attack.
Okay. 5 foot and
yep.
Attack it. Can yep. I full round it?
Yeah, you can do it as bad as it wants. It unfortunately was trying to keep its 10-foot aura of poison.
Am I then?
You dropped rage fighting in the round. You dropped rage in the round that you were confused.
I wasn't raging.
Okay.
I haven't raged yet. So should I?
No.
Can I rage or
You are full. You can rage, but you're full on attacking. Your attack is the only thing on your mind. You're not doing anything defensive.
Okay, so my 7, so becomes 17, hold on, so 17 with the thing becomes 17 plus, so it becomes 19? The bonus, let me check, yeah, it becomes 19, 17, yeah.
Okay. It's so AC 19. Of 20. When it goes full defense, it has AC 30.
It's like I'm rolling for you.
It's like what? Sorry?
It's like I'm rolling for you.
Okay. It maintains. It knows its own powers. This is how it hunts. It smiles at you. It doesn't attack you. But then... I guess you do get an AOO because he's going to fly up into the air and hover.
Can I climb?
You could try to jump and that sort of thing.
No, grab him.
He ascends. He's not a very good climber, so he's going to ascend 25 feet.
Yeah, it's AOO.
You miss. The creature then, so he ascends 25 feet. He can still just fly up.
Yeah, there's no flying in this.
He breathes down and then is going to drop on the next turn. He's breathing down with his breath weapon again. The poison save, or the saving throw versus the breath weapon, is a fort save DC 24.
Okay. Make it.
Okay, so you only take half the int damage, which is 6, becomes 3.
Ooh. Hold on. Okay, so minus 8. I'm almost unconscious.
What is your int at right now?
2.
Okay, you are animal intelligence right now. Animal intelligence. And will you take half wisdom damage, so 2 wisdom damage, and you're not confused? It technically has now attacked you, so you now have to attack the creature. You're in your confused 6. State, you are attacking the creature.
So 6. Okay. Now, I have evasion. Does that do anything?
Nope, it's a fort save. It's a big cloud of poison.
Okay.
Now's the time to roll a 20 or
a 90. Where is it? It's still up.
It's 25 air, right? Feet in the air, and then it breathed on you, and it's going to come back down next round.
Next round. Okay, I pull out my sword and hit Scorching Ray with it.
Nice!
So you have animal intelligence, which means you can't speak. I can't. It is a command action spell, so you're going, with your sword in your hand, and you can throw something at it, including the sword that's in your hand. You could grab, if you have missile weapons on you, and throw them.
No, I don't have any other weapons.
So you could throw your sword?
No. No,
Why are you not throwing your sword? Actually, the confusion spell, you have to attack the creature.
Okay, so I'll throw my non-lethal and grab my fiery one.
Okay, so you're throwing, you're two-hand throwing the great sword up at it with your two intelligence and what wisdom?
Oh, crap wisdom, crap attack.
All right, so I forgot to roll the mighty D4 to see how many more time, like, when can it breathe again? You can breathe in one round.
Oh, no.
Oh.
So Magnus throws his blade and scrambles for his other blade, and he's swinging it around, which means that it's its turn. The creature just glides back down to the ground and then breathes a cone of mist over Magnus. DC,
fort save.
DC 24 fort save.
We fail.
You take 5 int damage and 4 wisdom damage.
Unconscious.
Okay. Are they both at 0?
I think so. Give me a sec. 5, then yes. Minus 13. And 4, it's at 0.
Okay. Magnus staggers around and just falls over into minus the dirt. Three, I mean. There's a bunch of people like holding their mouths and backing away from the arena. Chebagas is yes. Oh, Magnus!
I'm gonna kill his fucking animal.
Not dead, incapacitated. Oh, all right. I will. This horrible creature just goes up to Magnus and kind of sniffs a little bit, and it takes a claw and makes a jagged wound down the side of your down the side of your face on your cheek, just a single claw mark.
Something to remember me by.
Of course, Magnus doesn't remember any of this.
Well, Magnus will remember this.
The poison aura goes down. And the thing stands up onto the end of its hindquarters. And yeah, the crowd is kind of indifferent with this. The crowd's like a hole in their mouths. It stinks. This is the last fight. Some of them are using this as an excuse to go drink elsewhere and just leave. The creature lords over Magnus a little bit, and then eventually there's a couple of whistles and like clicks from one of the wizards, and the creature, it's like it's dominated or something. It kind of like folds its wings back and goes over, and people put chains around it, and there are people in like weird gas masks that are handling it, and they drag the Venomanticore away. Chebagask has this sorry look on his face and just sort of shrugs it, kind of shrugs at Damian and Brogg.
Brogg, why don't you go pick him up?
Brogg, okay. Hey, Magnus, don't throw your sword away like that, Magnus.
Yeah, I don't know how long I'm going to be unconscious for. I believe I need a serious cleric here.
Magnus, you okay, buddy? You okay? He's not getting up!
Just carry him, we'll use the bull.
Okay.
And the winner, by stench it appears like it, the Venomanticore! And the Conclave of Crimson Scale is dealt their second loss.
Ooh.
I think you fed one of your monks to Brogg on purpose.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we did.
Yeah, you got to kill that thing right away, or it just kind of it destroys you. And it's not a CR6.
No, no, but I was just looking at the base CR6. I'm like, holy crap.
This thing is fucked. And I couldn't use my spring attack.
No, you couldn't.
Yeah, with a spring attacking Magnus in a wide open space, that might have been a bit of a different fight had he had missile weapons on him, but the confusion. Yeah.
Like... My friggin', I was looking at it too. I have the, what's his name? The returning... fucking spear.
I looked at it, I'm like, the venom breath, it does int and wisdom damage. Zero wisdom and int doesn't kill the character.
No.
It just knocks you out. It's not like a zero con. This is the perfect is the perfect creature for the arena.
Yep.
Well, aside from handling it would be bad, but you can actually reason with it. All right. Those were the fights at the pit of the old temple. One against the monks that
perfect spell life that? Bubble
air bubble might have been a good
air
spell.
Bubble
yeah. And Damian is now 30 talents richer.
Yeah, I think there will be a scene where you go to claim because I don't think anyone knows the actual clause. They know the contract as intended, not the contract as written.
He's gonna walk in all cocky, like, "Hey,
I'm coming here to collect. What do you mean to pay? No, to collect. Read here." And then, a cut scene like 2 hours later after you explain. You explain the legalese. So if you replace this variable with this variable, that is so evil and a weird series of events. I think on Saturday we're gonna do the fight of the two Ludi against each other.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, unless you guys have time to do it now, it'll probably take 2 hours.
No, I don't have time to do that. It's 1 a.m. here, man.
All right.
I am working this weekend though.
Okay. So, but it'll be the fight between the two Ludi.
Yeah, just whoever's... I know Mortensi's in the fight. Just whoever's running Mortensi, just... Remember, he's got heal spells. And he probably casts Divine Favor before the fight.
Yeah.
One spell and Magnus can just kill the thing. Right.
If I had cheated...
If I had the Archwizard worth of spells poured into me beforehand... Oh man, it was a good fight. It was a non-lethal fight, and it was a horrible monster that you now know what tricks you need to do. You need certain spells in order to fight it, and then it becomes a slugfest.
Yeah, the AC I had was good, but I needed something to save. I was thinking of getting a heroism, but.
Yeah, just a hold poison or a delay poison. Yeah, delay poison, a second level spell would be like, I'll deal with all the poison saves later. it had other poison too. It's like its claws and like spines and things like that had poison, a different type of poison. And then I think if you touched its like skin, it was poisonous. Like It's pretty gross. Remember when I said, when you guys were talking about poison, I'm not going to drink this. I might get poisoned. I was laughing on the inside and the outside. Okay. Hey, man. It's not... Stuff happens, and now you know...
I'm glad it happened here. It's like, if we fought against this unknown monster, and it fucked him. Yeah, all right. That's not bad. It's not a bad way to lose.
What do you want to call this match? Or this game? The pits.
The pits. What's this place called again? The pits.
The pits at Old Temple. The pit at Old Temple.
All right. The pit at Old Temples is just a fine name, I think, for this game.
Unless we come up with anything. Different. You get a little of XP. It might take Magnus some time to recover from this, though, because what is your int?
-3.
No, it stops at zero. What is it, your...
Zero. Oh, 10.
10, and then your wisdom is...
10. Yeah, that's right. 18, 18, 18, 10.
So, with 24-hour rest and not doctor care, it will take you 5 days to get all your ability points back. With doctor care, it'll take less. So, basically, Magnus will be bedridden for one full week after this fight.
Yeah, you can take out one of its eyes.
And you have a little scar, so you probably have like real charisma damage.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna meet up with Cherry Bass later.
In fact, you could put one charisma drain on your character sheet.
Yeah,
this is not damage; it's drain. Like you got scarred. You would need to. Lord Nebby's just going, suck it, Magnus. this fight was basically a cheap shot. Yep. This was like a lesson, but a lesson from your friends as opposed to a lesson from your enemies.
One charisma drain.
Remember, Mongo... Chepagash was crying after the giant spider Mongo died.
Well, it's either fucking Mongo or my gladiators.
Don't worry, he's got all sorts of new monsters now that he's paired up with these Imperial wizards. He's got all sorts of monsters at his disposal now.
I have to come into the cabinet of chemicals.
Welcome to season 2. All right.
God damn it. Yeah, I guess welcome to season 2 is a good name for us.
There was... What was Brog? Brog said something.
But the creature flew.
That was almost a song, but then we chuckled. Do you smell what...
The manticore is cooking.
What did the manticore say? It wasn't quite the, do you smell what it was cooking? Do you smell that? Something along the lines of that? Anyways. Pitted old temple.
The pit of stench.
Stinker. Hook, line, and stinker.
There we go.
But question, it did fly with the claws that it's not supposed, there's no flying in this, right?
No, it said there's no flying.
Yeah, there's no flying or no invisibility.
No. There's no flying if you say there's no flying in the contract. It's not a rule of the arena.
Was there a contract? Because we kind of shook on it.
Yep. There was a gentleman contract in a very loose rules where they concentrate on the contract. It was the invisibility was probably in there. There probably wasn't anything about flying. The creature can't fly very well. Like if it had tried to hover, it would have made horrible fly checks. But yeah, have a good night, guys. So hook, line, and stinker is a good one. I'm glad you guys enjoyed Kaithan the Unchained. That was pretty funny at the beginning.
That was funny.
Yeah.
I like that.
He just loves fighting, and he might even be. I was so close to actually building like a proper character sheet for this dude and giving him stats and like. of a spiked chain fighter in Pathfinder to see if like in this advanced age of Pathfinderdom. Yeah, we could tell Demon Lord that you were happy that Magnus got his butt kicked. I wonder if Magnus holds grudges. That's a really good question.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
It's like what is Magnus going to do against that Ludus, against the Manticore? Does he blame Chebagast? Does he blame the beast? Does he blame the wizards that are controlling the beast?
Now, see, Magnus, if we had a tiny little assassin, we could send him to kill
Chebagast. Magnus might not be as gentle with Chebagast creatures.
Right.
Here's a reminder for your dog. Here's a reminder for your dog. Here's a reminder for your... Slice too far in the head. Oops.
Now, did you bet on yourself?
Nope.
Think, yeah.
Nope. I'm going to fight a magical creature. Oh, really?
Boy, am I glad I didn't bet on you.
None of my gear, huh?
Nice. There are probably some angry people in the city that wanted to bet on the champion. Champion versus Magic Beast. Magic Magnus is invincible.
Man, fucking bad of luck.
No.
No.
And then, they hear not... he got knocked out by the creature's stink. Oh, really?
Well, breath weapon was breathing on him, but yeah.
Sorry.
Every fucker.
The rolls were not in your favor.
No, they were.
Fuck.
That was not cool.
Oh, and it was attacking like your two derp stats. What was your is 10 and 10?
10 yeah. and 10, baby. My
18, 18, 18, 10, 10, 10. Is that your build?
Yeah.
But yeah. 18, 18, 18.
Oh.
10, 10, 10.
This thing's Magnus's a nemesis, basically.
Give me my spring attack! I didn't have like four of my feet.
Oh, man. One spell, delay poison, and it would be like, okay.
Yeah,
we're going to have that potion on us all the time now.
Which means one less of something else. Cool. This was
fun. Fuck that rule.
I will see you guys on Saturday, or some of you on Saturday. Cool that you could hang out with us tonight, Mark.
That was pretty awesome.
Yep. And I hope you guys enjoy this as much as we do. Peace. Good night.
Cool. Night, guys. See ya. Thank you.